Sabrina.
Hey, guys. We're having a private party tonight.
Oh.
Yeah? So? So we're closed.
All right, well, we'll go somewhere else. What's going on?
Oh, Harley and Gus.
Oh, good. Well, good for them. Hey, how's your dad holding up?
What, is he sick or something?
No, her dad is, Frank Cooper, the police chief, and...
Oh, the dirty cop in the papers.
We're closed. That's what private party means. See you, Danny.
Yeah, all right, take care.
She didn't like me very much, you know.
Well, she used to.
Yeah, those really good old days. Well, it's early. Where do you want to go?
I don't know. We could, go to Towers. They got a nice view. Olivia's bar.
Can we go see Tony?
Come on, let's just drop it, okay?
Not
Please.
Until you tell me what's wrong.
There's nothing wrong. I just wasn't planning on seeing Tony tonight, that's all.
You mean you didn't want to see Tony?
I just want to show him my tattoo.
Oh, well then, let's get over there. Right away.
Wow, you guys had a fight.
No, you know...
About what?
Michelle... Can we just get out of here before the Spaldings and the Coopers show up and start throwing punches?
What did you and Tony fight about, Danny?
It's nothing. Tony and I are always fighting. If it's not one thing, it's something else. It doesn't matter.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, it matters to me.
Okay, well, bro, I'm gonna take off.
Okay.
Michelle, you look wonderful.
Thanks. Thanks. I feel really good. And I know if my memory doesn't come back, I'm on the right path.
That's good. I like to hear about it. Stop by the church sometime. We'll talk. Got a lot of people praying for you.
Thank you. That means a lot.
Good. Nice. Love you guys.
Yeah. See you soon.
All right. Talk to you later. Good day.
Okay, so you come barging in here like cops with a warrant. What's the deal? What's going on?
You and Danny had a fight, right?
Oh, well, Michelle, we do that sometimes.
Yeah, well, not with me around. You don't, okay? I already told Danny to cut it out. He wouldn't tell me what happened, but I think we need to settle this right here and right now.
Well, Michelle, I'm sure whatever it was my fault.
It usually is.
Okay, okay, I see. This is how it works. Everyone's all buddy-buddy here. No one's talking.
No, there's nothing to worry about. It's okay.
You know, I don't believe you, but whatever. Real reason I came. Ta-da! What do you think, huh? How cool is that? So then he asks me, like, you know, if I have a pattern or anything that I want, or if I looked at any books, and I said, well, yeah, I got something in mind. Symbol for ambition. So then he says, all right, turn around, show me the goods.
Oh, it just keeps getting better and better.
Oh, he's just mad because some other guy saw my good stuff.
To be honest with you, I would too. I mean, if I were Danny.
Okay, so are we done with this very exciting recap?
Okay, this is my first tattoo. Can a girl gloat a little? Jeez. Okay, ask me if it hurt. Come on, ask me if it hurt.
Okay, okay. Did it hurt?
No. Yes, it hurt like a mother.
Well, you'll get used to it. I mean,
Tony, I sweat so bad. I could have been in a wet t-shirt contest. But I have you to thank.
Thank me for what? You don't need to thank me.
No, you were my inspiration.
No, Michelle, millions of people have tattoos.
And
you don't
now
need to
I'm
thank
one of them.
You know what? Listen, it's getting late. I got to meet Bill for some business, so please.
Yeah? How's that going?
It's going. I hate to kick you guys out, but get out.
Fine. We'll go. We'll see you tomorrow?
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm. Might be busy. We'll see. I'm not sure.
I don't really take no very well. But whatever. Later.
Later.
Do you think he liked it? I thought he'd be, you know, more impressed being a tattoo connoisseur and all.
I don't know. Maybe you just took him by surprise. You know, you've been doing that a lot lately.
Not the same homemaker slash goody two-shoes mommy doctor wife anymore?
Hey, you know, you were always a lot more than that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm sorry that I dragged you all the way down here, but Tony's family, you know, and kind of feel like he's the only one who really gets me,
mm-hmm.
besides you,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Yeah.
No, you didn't drag me anywhere. I'd follow you to the end of the world. I'm stuck on you.
You have got a habit of always saying the right thing, whether it's corny or lovey-dovey.
Hey, what was corny about
that? I liked it. I liked it. I did.
Hey, Reba.
Danny,
hi. Are you working late?
Actually, no. Josh is meeting a client, and I am signing up for salsa lessons.
Oh, salsa lessons. Wow. Good for you. Good for you.
Actually, I got the idea from Michelle.
Michelle?
Mm-hmm. She just has this whole new energy and, I don't know, newness around her.
Oh, yeah.
Inspired me to kind of try something new for myself.
Yeah. Well, all this newness is making me feel pretty old.
I know this can't be easy for you, Danny.
You know, Reba, I'm all for Michelle exploring, whatever, finding who she is, whatever she wants to call it. But it's kind of difficult for me to give her her space at the same time looking out for her when I don't even know what she's doing from one minute to the next. It's ridiculous. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Speaking. Uh-huh. Well, wait, hold on. My wife didn't buy a chair from your store. She did. And a what? Yeah, hey, it's Danny. I need to see you. It's Michelle. She's, something has to be done. Okay. Thanks. I'm on my way. Just going a little crazy here.
What is this about Michelle?
Yeah, who else? I am so sick of tiptoeing around her and pretending that everything is okay.
Well, what happened?
Rick, it's what happens every day. It's what happened tonight. She disappears. She takes off without a word as to where she's going. Maybe, if I'm lucky, later on, she'll tell me where she was and what she was doing. But for the most part, I have no clue how she spends her time. Before I called you, I got a call from that store.
Egan's.
About some chair and bar set that she bought. Right.
Women shop, Danny. That's what women do. You're not upset about
She
this,
didn't
right?
bring the bar set and the chair to the house. At least not our house.
Well, where are they? Where'd she put them?
Who knows? I have no idea. It's the first I ever heard about it. This is what I'm saying, and this is what it's been like. One surprise after another. Last night, there was the tattoo.
Don't tell me she got a tattoo.
Oh, yes. You know, at least it's relatively tasteful. It's somewhere a Chinese character that means, just wait, ambition or something, right? Back here.
Oh, that's tasteful.
Yeah, where the sun basically does not shine. Well, not lately. I really can't take much more of this.
We can't lock her up, can we?
It's very tempting right now, believe me. Michelle has got to see what she's doing.
How?
Well, I was hoping that you guys could maybe talk to her. Somebody's got to talk to her, somebody who can listen and explain to her that what she really needs to be doing right now is spending her time with her family. Someone has to explain this to her, someone other than me, because we are obviously not on the same wavelength about this.
You're in luck.
Why?
We're expecting my mother any minute now.
Felicia?
Mm-hmm. We can listen and get through to somebody better than a therapist.
Yo, people, here's a lady that's made Springfield a party in town again. Give it up for our hostess this evening, Michelle Santos. Come on.
Hey, handsome.
Hey. Well, you're in a good mood.
Carpe diem. What's up?
Well, listen, I ran into Rick and Mel at Towers, and they invited us to have dinner with them. So what do you think? You up for it?
Sure. Why not? I'll be right there.